Hello, you are welcome to the third module of Teach Yourself QuickBooks. This section is also another important part of QuickBooks that you need to understand. Before now, we have actually discussed how you can get yourself familiar with the different versions of QuickBooks software, and the previous module, which is the second one, was on how to set up a company. I guess by now you should be able to know how to set up a company with that guide, because it's quite straightforward and easy. You don't need to break a sweat. You just follow the guide, repeat the process over and over again. You should be good to go in setting up a company. So I do not expect you to pay a consultant to set up a company for you again right now. Now, this third module is another important part of QuickBooks. Besides, it's very, very key. After you have learned how to set up a company and you have your dashboard like this, as you're saying, the next thing to do is, how do you bring in your balances? Initially, I've been talking about balances, opening balance, and you may be wondering, oh, what balance am I talking about? Now, we are going to discuss those balance here right now, so that you would actually scale that. Now, the balance I'm talking about here, I'm talking about certain opening balances, because you can't start entering transactions and say, oh, because I've named set up a company, let me start entering invoice, let me start receiving payments. No, most of the time, it's always assumed that you are already existing business. So the question is, what happens to the past transactions that has happened in your business? What's happened to the past record? So you need to close your book and bring in your balance into the system. Now, I always mention one thing when I train my clients. They should be able to understand a very key term here, which is conversion date. Conversion date is the date you're converting from manual accounting to automated, or from other accounting software into QuickBooks. So in this section here, we are assuming that we are choosing, we are using today's date. That's the first of this month, which is what we chose at the point of setting up a company. So when you're setting up your company and you have this balance on ground, it should be easier for you to now enter a transaction. Now, what are the balances I'm talking about? The first balance you need to know is what we call your customer balances. Definitely, every business should have a customer or client. To some business, it could be called a customer. To some other business, it could be called a client. To some other businesses too, probably like private schools, their customers are their students. So whichever name you use, you should be able to understand that your customers are the people that you sell your product or your service to. So the first balance you need to bring in is your customer balance. And when you're bringing in your customer, you don't just bring in the balance as a whole. Example, let's assume that we have 10 customers that are owing us right now, and the total amount these customers are owing us is 20,000 naira. You can't bring in 20,000 naira into QuickBooks. No, you need to bring in the breakdown of this 20,000 naira. So the system calculates the breakdown and give you the whole amount. So in bringing your opening balance, the first thing you need to have is your customer and their balances. So how do you bring in your customers and their balances? On the QuickBooks dashboard here, you will see customers. If you don't go through this section, you can go through this section here. When you go through the section, you will see customer center. They are all the same. It's either you use customer center here or you click here. So if you go here, you click customer center. Customer center will take you to a dashboard. Now, we'll take you to your window. Now, this is the window you use to manage your customer. When I say manage your customer, I mean adding a new customer, deleting an already existing customer, or editing the customer information. But you cannot delete a customer with an existing balance. I'm going to demonstrate that here. So how do you add a new customer? To add a new customer in QuickBooks or an already existing customer, you go to add, say, new customer. When you click new customer here, it will ask you to enter the customer name and the opening balances. Now, why is this showing 19th of May? It's because we chose this as our today's date. If you are selected beginning balance, it would have taken this balance back to March. You can remember that our opening balance was, as our first month of financial year was March. So if I had chosen beginning of the year, it would have been 1st of March. But because we selected today's date, that's why it's picking today's date. So now we're going to set up our customer. Let's assume one of our customer here is Isaac Enterprise. So you enter Isaac Enterprise here, you can see the opening balance here. Now the opening balance here is the amount Isaac Enterprise is owing as at 19th of March. So when you talk to your accountant and say, oh, is Isaac Enterprise owing us as at 19th of March, which is today's date? Say yes, they are owing us. How much are they owing us? Use 50,000 naira here. So now let me clarify something. Assuming you made a sale of 100,000 to Isaac Enterprise, and Isaac Enterprise paid you 50,000 naira with a balance of 50,000 naira, what you will enter here is the remaining balance, not the sales transaction, because what you are interested in at this point is to bring in opening balance. So the opening balance as at when we're setting up this QuickBook is 50,000 naira, which is outstanding. So with other information here, you can always enter other information here. So if you are interested in tracking the customer detail, like the phone number, the address, you can always enter the full name here. You can always enter additional information, I mean. Yeah, here the full name could be the contact person here. Maybe the contact person here is still Mr. Isaac. Then you can enter the phone number here. Then you can enter other relevant information here. Very important. Now, that is if you wish now to track relevant information regarding Mr. Isaac, like mobile phone, the email address, and all that. It's also important that you do that. So, if that is the case, if you have entered the transaction, if you have entered details of Mr. Isaac as a customer, then you click OK. What I'm doing here is I'm making it simple and straightforward. Even though we have other menu here, what you need to get yourself familiar with first is how to add a customer, because I'm keeping it simple and making it easier for you to get started with QuickBooks. That's why we call it teach yourself QuickBooks. So it's something you should be able to understand from scratch and all that. As you progress, you can always extend your icon to other features, but the features you need to start up right now is what I will focus on, so that you don't get yourself confused and all that. So here I will click OK. Once you click OK on this section, you will see now that Mr. Isaac has been added to the system. That's our first customer. Now let's add another customer again. You go to new, you click new customer. Now you add another customer. Let's say another customer here is XC Shipping Company. That's another customer that we have. Now XC Shipping Company. Now in this scenario, let's assume that as at when we're setting up our QuickBooks, XC Shipping Company is not owing us anything at all. The first scenario is owing us 50,000. Second scenario is not owing us at all. What do you need to do? We leave it like that. You don't have to enter anything. That means that if you are an already existing business, you can use the first scenario to add customers. But if you are a new business that is starting out and no customer is owing you right now, but you already have customers that are already waiting to buy your product but they are not owing you, then you will just enter the customer name and leave the opening balance empty, which means they are not owing you. Then you click OK. So you can see from here that we have added two customers. Now let's add another customer with an outstanding balance here. Now you can come here and put Apex Global as a customer. Oh, Apex Global is owing us 150,000 naira as of when we're doing our setup. So you can come here, you enter your 150,000 naira opening balance. So this opening balance means that as at when we're doing setup in QuickBooks, this customer is still owing us. So you come here, like I said, you can always enter details of this customer. You click OK. You can see that it has been added. So with that, you can add all your customers one after the other. Now, like I said before, this is an accounting software. You don't have to wait till month end to build your report. With the two entries that we have made, with the three entries that we have made so far, system can give us a summary report of all the amounts customers are owing us. When you go to reports, you go to customers and receivables, you see customer balance summary. After you click customer balance summary, you can see here, it will show you the customers. These are the two customers we've entered, Apex Global 150, Isaac Enterprise 50, which means our total balance is what, 200,000, which means we have 200,000 that customers are owing, that they are yet to pay us. So this is a real-time software. You close it, that is for customer. So these are the basic scenario you need to understand when setting up your customer in QuickBooks. It's either they are owing you or they are not owing you. If they are owing you, you enter the figure under the opening balance. If they are not owing you, you leave the balance like that, then you click save. That's the first one on customers and all that. But if you have multiple customers, let's assume you have over like 500 customers, like the setup we did for a school where they have multiple customers and all that. Now, I would advise that we send a mail to info@accountingsoftware.com.ng. We are always willing to assist you on how to do an import into QuickBooks from Excel. It is very, very important. But here, we want to keep it low to show you how to add new customer and all that. So, when you're done with this customer information, you come here, you click close. We are done with customer. We've added our customer. You can follow the process to add more customer. The next one here is, how do we add our supplier? You go here, you click supplier. Supplier center and customer center, they are almost the same thing. It's just the English. The way you add your customer, that is how you add your supplier. Who are your suppliers? Your suppliers are the people you buy your products from, or people that render service to you. Now, at the point of setting up your QuickBooks too, if you are adding your supplier, it's also important for you to check if there are account payable balance. That is, if you are owing any of these suppliers at any point in time. So, as at when you're doing your setup, that is where you need to ask this question. It is important. Now, to add a supplier, you come here, you click new. Here, you know a supplier. Assuming we buy from Dangote, we enter Dangote PLC. The question is, as at when we're doing setup in QuickBooks, are we owing them? You can remember the first scenario. The first scenario is, we are setting up our customer, are they owing us? But in this scenario, which is for supplier, we are asking if we are owing them. If we are owing Dangote, you enter the figure here as the account opening balance for Dangote. You can also see that it's picking at the same day. If you're interested in tracking the customer, the supplier detail, like the company name, first name, full name here, and the first title is like the contact person, job title, the phone number, you can always enter the information and all that. Like I said, we are going to keep it low and simple for you to understand. We're not going to get complex in this system. You master the system when you get used to the basic aspect or the basic feature. So if you're done adding your supplier, you click OK. You can see that we have our supplier here. Now, second scenario is, we want to add the supplier with no balance. So here, you can enter Flomi. Oh, Flomi is our supplier. But at the point of doing this setup, we are not owing them. That means as at 19th, we've checked our record and we realize that we finish paying them. So that means you leave your balance to be zero. Then you click OK. Let's add another supplier again. We'll come here, put Sabi Limited as a supplier. Sabi Limited. Now, as a point we're doing our setup, are we owing Sabi Limited? These are questions the accountant should be able to answer. We'll check our book. We'll say yes, we are owing Sabi Limited 34,000 naira. Then you enter 34,000 as opening balance. You can see that as a point we're doing our setup, we need to look at the account balance across all business parties. Business parties are people you do your business with. It's either they are your supplier or your customer. Then you click OK. If you click that, you can see that we've added our suppliers. We've added the ones we are owing and the ones we are not owing. To confirm this, the way we did for customers, you can see that system can generate a report that will show you total amount you are owing your suppliers. Then you come here, you see suppliers and payables, you see supplier balance summary, you can see here Dangote PLC, you can see Sabi Limited. So total of the two will give you 63,000, which means we are owing our suppliers 3,000, which is our account payable balance too. Now also, in looking at these few reports that we've entered so far, you can also go down to check your balance sheets. Here, when you go to your reports, memorize report, accountant, you see your balance. Your balance sheet will also show you the few transactions that you've entered. You can see that our account receivable balance, which is made up of our customer balances, is 200. You can see our account payable balance, which is made up of our supplier balances, our account payable balances, is what, 63,000 naira. So while we are entering transactions from the front end, our report is being viewed from the back end. So it's very important for you to know how to set up your customer and how to set up your supplier. It's straightforward. Go to your customer center, add new customer. Go to your supplier center to add a new supplier. So you should be able to understand this particular aspect very, very well. So we are done with adding our supplier. Now the next thing we need to know how to add, like I said before, the first opening balance is your customer, second opening balance is your supplier, the third opening balance here is your bank, because every movement of funds in a business always go through your bank. So it's also important for you to know how to add your bank and account balances there. So as at 19th of May, the other question we should be asking ourselves is, how much do we have in the bank? So now we need to ask ourselves and look at the bank balance as at that period. Mind you, whatever balance we are using will always be at the close of business hour, at the close of business day. So here, to add our bank in QuickBooks, following this procedure, it is very, very simple. You will go to chart of accounts. Now, I actually explained chart of accounts initially, which is under what we're doing, our company setup. So, but I'm going to dedicate a whole module for chart of account. But here, I'm going to show you how to add a bank. So, in your QuickBooks, just follow this procedure on how to add a bank. Just go to your account, you see new. When you click new, you can see different categories. We have our income, expenses, fixed asset, bank, and all that. Now, I'm going to dedicate this section to a module. So, but for the purpose of this setup here, because you are only adding a bank, you will come here, you will select bank. Like I said, chart of account is an account that categorizes all your transactions to either income, expenses, assets, or liability. So for the purpose of this particular bank balance, we are only going to select bank. So here you select bank. What this means is that the new account we want to add to this particular QuickBooks is our bank account here. Then we come here, we click continue. So the first scenario here is, let's assume we have two banks. We have account with GTB. You enter GTB as the account name here. Then the another question you ask yourself is, as of when we're doing the setup, how much do we have in GTB as of 19th of May? You can see that 19th of May is the balance, is the date we are choosing for all balances. So here you come here, enter opening balances. Statement ending date has to be as at 19th. So statement ending balance, we will now select, oh, as at 19th we have 123,000 naira in GT bank. Then you come here, you click OK. Here, when you click OK, you click save and close. Now from here, we have added our GTB bank. Now you can see from this section here that we now have a GTB balance. To confirm this, when you go to your balance sheets, under the banking section or under the current assets, you should see GT Bank appear. Now, when you come here, you will see here under the current asset, Cash at Bank, you now have GT Bank. So that's how to add your GT Bank. Now, that is not the only account we have. This, now we are assuming that we only have one account. Now, second scenario is, if we are adding another bank in which we have two different type of accounts, we have a savings account and we have a current account. How do you add the bank? Now, this is what you do. Assuming you're selecting Zenith Bank, to add your bank, we are going to first add the name of the bank. So here you go to account, you click new, you select your bank, continue. Now, the name of the bank is Zenith Bank. So you will enter Zenith Bank here. When you enter Zenith Bank, you don't enter any balance because we are entering two different types of accounts. We are entering current accounts and we are entering savings account. So the first thing you need to do is to add Zenith Bank first, then you click save and close. When you do that, now we are going to add our savings account. You will realize one thing, that when you add your savings account and add your current account, system will add the two accounts together to give you the total balance you have in Zenith Bank. So here you come again to account, you click new. Now we are adding our savings account, you click bank, you click continue. Now the account we are adding now will be savings account. So you come here, you enter savings. Now, because that savings account is under Zenith Bank, you will now click sub account of, you now select Zenith Bank. That is when you now enter the balance on the savings account. So the balance on the savings account is 100,000 naira. Mind you, statement date will also be as at 19, because everything we are going to be doing will be on 19. Why are we selecting 19? That was when we chose as the date we want to start tracking our finance in QuickBooks. So here you click OK. When you do that, you click save and close. Now look at the way the system will pick it. We have Zenith Bank as the overall bank. We now have savings account. Now let's add another account, which is current account. You go down to accounts, you click new. Once you click new, you select your bank. When you select your bank, you click continue. When you click continue, then you enter your current account. You enter current here. It has to be a sub account of what? Your Zenith Bank. Then you enter the balance in your current account. Assuming you have a current account balance of 500,000 naira, you enter it. Statement ending date is 19th. Then you click OK. When you click that, you click save and close. Now look at what has happened. You will see that our Zenith Bank account now has 600,000 naira, which is addition of 500,000 for current account and 100,000 for savings account. So you can see the scenarios that we practiced here. The first one is GT Bank. We only have one account with GT Bank, which is 123. Second scenario is we have two accounts in a bank. We have the current account and we have a savings account. Firstly, you will enter the name of the bank first. You don't enter any balance. Second, you enter a savings account. Then you will now select a sub account of Zenith Bank. Second, you enter a current account. You now select a sub account of Zenith Bank. This is how to add your bank balances. So if you have so many accounts you can always follow this process to add all your bank accounts. You can also ask, what if I want to add my domiciliary account? Don't add that now, until we talk about foreign currency, because at the point of setting up our foreign currency, that is where I'm going to explain how to add a foreign bank account, like a domiciliary account. Then I would have explained how to activate your exchange rate. But for now, just follow the process of adding your local bank first. When you get to the module on international currencies, I'm going to show you how to do that. So look at this, follow this step. Add your bank account, add your bank balances. The bank balance you are going to add should be at the close of business day in that particular day. The date you're choosing as your conversion date, that's the date you're migrating from other accounting software to QuickBooks, or the day you want to start tracking your finance. That is the day you should use as your opening balance. That means the bank balance as at the end of that closing date. That's what you should use. So you need to understand that very, very well. So you can always go over the video, replay it, and look at how I've added the bank account, both GTB with one account and Zenith Bank with savings and current. Now the third aspect of our setup sorry, the fourth aspect, we've talked about the customer, we've talked about the supplier, we've talked about how to add your bank. Now, another important area is your VAT. Like I said before, when we're setting up the company, the system asks, do we want to charge VAT? We said yes, that is why it appeared here. If you are selected no, it wouldn't have appeared. So how do we set up our VAT so that when we sell products to customers, 5% will be multiplied to that particular sales and also recorded on the system as VAT. The first thing you need to do is to learn how to set up VAT. To set up VAT in QuickBooks, you click Manage VAT on this system. When you click Manage VAT on the system, a window will show up. Now, this is the window you use to set up your VAT. Now, you will now go down to Change VAT Setup. When you click Change VAT Setup, this is where your setup starts from. Welcome to VAT Setup Wizard. What are we going to do here? Well, the fourth option, set up VAT for additional country that supports QuickBooks. This is assuming that you already have VAT on your system. The other option is change an existing VAT. You use this option if the government has reviewed the VAT rate. Oh, maybe the VAT rate currently is 5% and now it has been reviewed to either 10% or reduced to 2%. And you want to change the VAT on your system, you select change existing VAT. But if you want to add a new VAT rate, oh, we're just adding a new one for the first time, or want to add a new VAT rate. Anytime you want to add a new VAT rate, you have to select this one here. Anytime you want to change an existing VAT, you select this one. If you want to add a new VAT, you select this one, but you only add your VAT once. The other one is add a new tax, including a new tax agency. This is like you are adding a new VAT collected by another tax agency. So the one that is mostly suited for Nigerian business and that is workable and easy to set up is this particular one, third one, add a new VAT rate. So select add a new VAT rate here. When you select add a new VAT rate, you click next. When you click next, system will ask you your VAT agency. Now, our VAT agency here is Federal Inland Revenue Service. It's not the system, so that means you select new. Selecting new means you want to add a new VAT agency. You click next. When you click next, you now see name of tax. The tax we are adding here is called VAT. So we select VAT. When do you want to report our VAT? Is it on a monthly basis? Is it quarterly, annually, and all that? So you select on a monthly basis. Name of agency. The agency in charge of VAT in Nigeria is FIRS. So you see FIRS Nigeria. So that is what you are going to enter here. Now, when do you owe the tax? If you remember when we were doing our setup, when the system asked, do we charge VAT? We said yes. It's now asking what reporting method do we use. We selected accrual basis, and I've explained that before. So that's what is coming up here. So you leave this the way it is. Then you click next. Now, do you apply this tax to sales on purchase? To sales or purchase? To some business, they are only interested in tracking VAT on sales. Some other business, they also track both tax on sales and purchases. Let me explain that. When you charge your customer VAT, when you sell to them and you collect VAT from the products that you have sold to them, now you are also expected to track all the VAT that you have paid to your supplier, because when you buy from your supplier, you are also paying VAT alongside the product you're buying. Now, the idea is that the amount that you have paid to your supplier is supposed to be deducted from what you have collected. So that amount is like VAT reclaim. So if you collect 100 naira from your customer as VAT on sales and you have paid 50 naira to your supplier as VAT on purchases, 100 minus 50, it is the remaining 50 naira that you are supposed to remit to your tax authority. But most businesses don't do that. The reason is that they don't have accurate record on their VAT. So what you need to understand here is you need to be able to track your VAT on sales effectively and VAT on purchases. But in most cases, I see that most businesses, they charge VAT on sales only. So in this scenario, if you track both VAT on sales and VAT on purchases, you click I collect this tax on sales I make. You also click I collect this tax on sales on the purchase I make. From this first one, you're saying you collect tax on sales you make to your customer. On the second one, you pay this tax on purchases you make from your supplier. Then here is like I get tax credit when I pay tax on purchases. That's like all the tax that you have paid to your VAT, your supplier as VAT, you deduct it from your tax on sales, which is like a credit for you. So definitely you have to select these two. So here we are setting up a VAT that will track both sales and also on purchases, so that when we're generating a VAT report, it will calculate what we have collected and what we have paid. No, what you have paid will be deducted from what you have collected. It is now the balance that will remit to tax authority. If there's a balance, we will remit. If there's no balance, we'll leave it like that. If what you have collected is less than what you have paid, the remaining balance will be carried forward until we finish getting all the credit on what you have paid to supplier. We will never remit the remaining percentage to the government. So the next one is show account detail. Now, at the point of setting up your QuickBooks, it's likely that you might have been collecting VAT before now. That is before the 19th of May. The question is, what happened to that balance? You need to bring in that balance into QuickBooks. So an account to track that is VAT payable account, which is a liability account. Then the opening balance here is the total amount that you have collected as VAT, which we are yet to remit to the government before you did the setup on QuickBooks as at 15, which is also your opening balance. That's where you're going to enter here. That means the system we're using before to record our accounts, what amount is it giving us as our VAT now? So assuming now that we have a VAT of 1290, so what this is telling us is that 1290.65 is what we have collected as VAT and are yet to be remitted in QuickBooks as at now. So we'll bring that in as an opening balance. When you do that, you click next. So here you will now say, what is the rate when you make a sale? The question now is, what is our VAT rate in Nigeria? It's 5%. You enter 5, you click next. What is the rate when you make? So VAT on sale and VAT on purchase in Nigeria is 5%. Then you click next. So here we have VAT code. Now this VAT code doesn't come with any rule. It's like a code that lets you identify the 5% that you have entered. So there's no rule that comes with it. You can decide to say 111, you can decide to remove it, and you can say 222. Any code you use, but the most important thing is for you to know that anytime you see this code, know that it's 5% VAT. So we are going to select 111. So here you now say this VAT code is for new rates only and all that. So when you are done, you click next. When you click next, you review what you have done so far and you click finish. We have finished setting up our VAT. It's straightforward. I would advise you to go through this process over and over again to learn how to set up your VAT. Now we have set up a VAT of 5%. How do we confirm that what we have entered is correct? To confirm that, we'll go to invoice. When you go to invoice, you enter a figure and you select that VAT code. So here, let's go down. Assuming we made a sale of 1000 naira, and under VAT, you can see the VAT code of 5%. If you select this 5% here, your VAT should give you 50. So 5% of 1000 should give you 50. You can see that 50 is here. So if you made a sale of 1000 naira and you're charging a VAT of 5%, what the customer is supposed to give you is 1050 naira. So that shows that our VAT setup is correct. It's very important and also very necessary for us to confirm our VAT. So these are the basic setup you need to learn. You need to learn how to add your customer. You need to learn how to add your supplier. You need to learn how to add your bank. You need to learn how to add your VAT. These are the basic things you need to learn how to add that will help you get started in QuickBooks easily. Now, assuming now that we have other expenses that are outstanding too. For example, we have our NEPA bill, we have our LOMA. So if you have expenses that are outstanding when you are setting up your QuickBooks, you also need to learn how to bring that into the system. Very important. But I'm going to show you how to do that under chart of account. The bedrock or the basis of every transactions we are going to enter in this system lies on chart of account. So that's why I'm devoting a whole module for chart of account, because the reports you're going to be seeing from the front end are all coming from chart of account. So I'm going to devote a whole module on how to do that. Now, the few transactions that we have entered how can we see them on the balance sheet? When you go down to reports, memorize, reports, accountants, balance sheets, when you click your balance sheet, you can see all the balances that we've brought in so far. You can see how our balance sheet looks like with the little entry that we have done. You can see now that we have our GT Bank, we have our Zenith Bank, which is a combination of savings and current. We have our account receivable balance, we have our account payable balance, we have our VAT. You can see the VAT also is coming up here. Now when you scroll down a little bit in the system here, you will also see other balances on the system so far. So what we are doing here is that we are automating our accounting system, so we don't have to be doing two things. You will enter transaction, you will now have to start building reports. System is doing everything automatically and on a real time basis. So it's very important for you to know how to enter your opening balance. This is a basic system, this is a basic requirement. So I do not see reason why you have to pay a consultant again to do this. This video will show you everything you need to learn in using QuickBooks for your business effectively. So we've been able to conclude on how to set up your opening balance. I would advise you to practice this yourself. Set up your customer, set up your supplier, add a bank, add your VAT, and go to your report and see the way it comes up. By the time you do this over and over again, I believe you should be a master in setting up your opening balances. So in our next module, we are going to discuss how to set up your chart of account. Mind you, we are still doing basic setup. First one was accounting, second one is our opening balances, the other one is our chart of accounts. Thank you. If you have any information, so if you have any question to ask, you can always send it to info@accountingsoftware.com.ng.